أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونشكره ونستعين به ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا ومرشدنا وحجتنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وفي رواية وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وطاعته وأحثكم على التمسك بهدي قرآنه وسنة نبيه فقد قال الله جل من قائل أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم إخوة الإيمان عندما نسعد بقراءة القرآن ونتمعن بقراءة القرآن نجد بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يضرب في القرآن أمثال كثيرة الله سبحانه وتعالى يخبرنا بأن هذه الأمثال لم تضرب جزافاً، وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس وما يعقلها إلا العالمون، كما في سورة العنكبوت: وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون، كما في الحشر. الأمثال كثيرة، ولكن هنالك مثل يتكرر أكثر من غيره في القرآن الكريم، ألا وهو مثل المطر الذي يتنزل من السماء على الأرض الميتة الهامدة، فإذا بالحياة تضرب بها من جديد. ولعلنا نلاحظ بأنه في كل مرة يذكر فيه مثل المطر الذي ينزل على الأرض الجافة، يكون الحديث إما قبل المثل أو بعده عن القرآن الكريم. دعونا نأتي إلى حديقة سورة النحل، آيتان صغيرتان واحدة بعد الأخرى، الآية رقم 64 والآية رقم 65 من سورة النحل. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: وما أنزلنا عليك الكتاب إلا لتبين لهم الذي اختلفوا فيه وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون. هذه آية 64، الحديث: وما أنزلنا عليك الكتاب القرآن إلا لتبين لهم الذي اختلفوا فيه وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون. والله أنزل من السماء ماء فأحيا به الأرض بعد موتها، إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يسمعون. صدق الله العظيم. إخوة الإيمان، هذا المثال كما ذكرت لم يضرب جزافا، والله سبحانه وتعالى يشبه لنا بأن نزول الوحي بالقرآن على قلب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ومن ثم انتقال هذا الفيض الرباني إلى قلوب المؤمنين، يشبه تماما الماء الذي ينزل من السماء على الأرض الميتة الجافة التي لا حياة فيها، فإذا ما نزل المطر تحولت إلى نبات وثمر وأشجار. وانظروا معي في نفس الحديقة، في نفس سورة النحل، ولكن قبل آيات من الآية 64 و65: وأنزل من السماء ماء، أو وهو الذي أنزل من السماء ماء لكم منه شراب ومنه شجر فيه تسيمون ينبت لكم به الزرع والزيتون والنخيل والأعناب ومن كل الثمرات إن في ذلك لآية لقوم يتفكرون. انظروا إلى تعداد ما يخرجه المطر من النبات، ينبت لكم به الزرع، يعني الخضروات والأشياء والزيتون والنخيل والأعناب، وبعد ذلك ذكر ومن كل الثمرات. هذا يدلنا أن هنالك نوعين من النبات، نوعين من النبات، نوعا يحتاج إلى عناية منا، وإذا لم نعتني به ونشق الجداول لكي يصل الماء أو الترع التي تأتي بالماء إلى ذلك الزرع وإلى شجر الزيتون وإلى النخيل وإلى الأعناب، وإذا ما لم نهتم بأن ننزع تلك الحشائش الضارة فإن ذلك الزرع سيموت. وهنالك غابات الأمازون التي تخرج من غير عناية منا ومن غير ما اهتمام منا، لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يهتم بها من كل الثمرات. في غابات الأمازون يعني أنواع من الشجر والمزروعات والأشياء التي تخرج لا نهتم بها. فإذا هنالك نوعان، نوع الذي نزرعه والنوع الذي يخرج بنفسه. كذلك القرآن. اسمحوا لي أن أنتقل إلى اللغة الإنجليزية لأن الوقت لا يسمح لكي نستطرد باللغة العربية. When we enjoy reading the Quran, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses examples, parables, lots of parables, lots of examples to bring the ideas close to our understanding. And one of the most common, frequent parables, examples in the Quran is that of rain falling on a dead piece of land, on a dead earth. And after that rain falls, then this land starts to grow and the plants start to appear on the surface of the earth. وترى الأرض هامدة فإذا أنزلنا عليها الماء اهتزت وربت وأنبتت من كل زوج بهيج. This is an example from Surah Al-Hajj that you see that this land is dead. But then as rain falls on it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had placed seeds inside this land, and scientists showed us that those seeds start to shiver and shake. They measured that shaking, and then plants will come forward and fruits, and we start to eat from that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses this example so frequently, and I noticed that every time this example of rain falling on dead land is mentioned, either before it or after it, there is talk in the Quran about the Quran, as if to alert us that look, I'm not mentioning those examples just in vain. I'm mentioning them and I want you to just look and enjoy for yourselves that this is the example of the Quran. The same as rain brings life to a dead earth, Quran brings life to a dead nafs. If our nufus, if our inner selves are really dormant and dead and dry and lifeless, now we know the answer how we can bring life to our inner self. There's absolutely nothing but the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Nahl mentions two ayat. He says in ayah 64, we did not reveal down or send down the Quran upon you, O Muhammad, except for the purpose that you will clarify for them that which they differ therein, and as a source of guidance and a source of mercy for people who have faith. And then immediately after that, and Allah, take notice, and Allah brings down water from the sky and causes dead landscape to come to life again. Verily, in that is a sign of power for people who listen. For people who listen. People who turn themselves away from the recitation of the Quran are not going to pay heed. They are not going to understand the parable. So here, alhamdulillah, we are coming for the purpose of understanding the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers, you know, very quickly, and sisters, I would say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alerting us. Nothing but the Quran will bring life to you again. Let us not kid ourselves. We have been experiencing, as Muslims, slow death. Let's not kid ourselves. We have been slowly dying. We have been even quoting the Quran to justify killing people. We have been quoting the Quran to justify doing mischief to others. We have been quoting the Quran to justify injustice towards our spouses. We have been quoting the Quran to justify improper distribution of inheritance among members of the same family. We have been quoting the Quran to mislead humanity, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. This is the Quran. It is not to misguide. It is a source of guidance. أَلِفْ لَامْ مِيمْ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This is the source of guidance. What's happening to us? You know what is happening to us? We've been meeting, going to workshops, listening to YouTube, listening to lectures, coming to functions, searching for an answer. And the answer is within our reach. But you know what? When I point here, for many, this is the place of the Quran. It's on the shelf. But the Quran, in order to bring life to us as a community, in order to light the legacy of the Quran in our nufus, we need to reach the Quran and see how it is used for building, how we can share it with others. The Quran, and please forgive me, wallahi, I do not intend to belittle any good activity of any brother or sister. I know that we come here before Jumu'ah Salat starts and we take Quran, Mus'haf, and we start to read, and then as the adhan is given, we put it back. And I'm not saying that all of us do that, or this is bad. But I'm saying that the Quran is not to come as a sprinkle, as a radhadh. The Quran should be فَإِن لَمْ يَكُنْ وَابِلٌ فَطَلْ. The Quran should fall on us through building legacies and lighting the legacy of the Quran in our lives. What does the Quran say about educating non-Muslims? What does the Quran say about older people in the community? What does the Quran say about education in the community? What does the Quran say about the dead? What the Quran says about women's activities? What does it say? We need to build and share with others. And I'd like to tell us a short story. There used to be a community wherein every year they have a competition among corn farmers for the best produce of corn. And for many years in a row, the same farmer was number one. And they wanted to find out, what's your secret? So they came to him and they were interviewing him. How come you are at the top? You are number one every year for many years. You know what he said? He said, every year I take the best seeds of my crop and I distribute them to all my neighbors. They looked at him and they said, what are you talking about? You know, they are entering the competition as well, and if you give them your best seeds, they may win against you. He said, no, you don't understand. When I give them the best seeds, I know that the wind will carry the pollen from their farms to my farm. And if the seeds I give them are bad seeds, or if they have bad seeds and the wind will carry bad pollen to my plants, I will not get the best produce. So I have to give them the best seeds and distribute it all around me so that when the wind plays to fertilize my corn stalks, I will get the best plants. End of story. Brothers and sisters, if we claim and we know that we have the best seeds, that we have the best for humankind, if we do not distribute those beautiful seeds to all the people around us, when the wind blows, it will carry our way very bad pollination. And you know what? This is exactly what is happening. If you ask, why do we have youth from our community using drugs? Why do we have them engaging in promiscuous activities? Why do we have them go the wrong way? Why do we have high divorce rate? Why do we? You know why? Because we are not distributing the good seeds to the farmers around us. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. The Quran is a legacy. And this legacy has to be lit. This legacy is nur. This legacy is something that has to be shared. This legacy, if used properly, we may have a chance, God willing, to bring those misguided, claimed Muslims to the straight path. We may do all of that, but we've got to first light the legacy right here in our community. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will accept our dua. آمين يا رب العالمين. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. My dear brothers and listening sisters, you know, even a very short ayah of the Quran, four words, a very short ayah, that there isn't a single Muslim, even a year and a half, 2 years old, when we start to teach them the Quran, we start with that ayah. It's the first ayah that any Muslim, and even lots of non-Muslims, know this ayah. And they use it. But you know, even that ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of its importance, prepared us to receive it in the Quran way before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because the Quran is a very important gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we need to embrace it and light it in our hearts. You know, I'll tell you very, very quickly about this ayah because it was very heavy, even though it's only four words, was very heavy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the first time He allowed a human being to use it, He allowed him to use only two words of it because it was so heavy to use it at the first time. One time, just like this, He used half of it, two words. And that was Nuh alayhi salam. I know I'm keeping you in suspense, but I'm coming to it. And then the second one, way after Nuh alayhi salam, the first one who used it in full, but way before the Quran was revealed in full, was Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam. Prophet Nuh, when the whole world was going to drown, there was a deluge. It was, that's it. People were corrupt. And there was a deluge that was going to eat everybody up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extracted a nucleus from humans and animals. A nucleus, and said, you go on the vessel. You go on the fulk. What did Nuh alayhi salam said to those people, وَقَالَ رَكَبُوا فِيهَا, in Surah Hud. وَقَالَ رَكَبُوا فِيهَا, listen to this now. بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَجْرِيهَا وَمُرْسَاهَا إِنَّ رَبِّي لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ صدق الله العظيم. So are you starting now to guess what the ayah is? Nuh alayhi salam used two words. He said, بِسْمِ اللَّهِ. But then at the time of Sulaiman alayhi salam, when the queen of Sheba received a letter from Sulaiman, because he said, what are you doing? You are worshipping the sun other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَتْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ إِنِّي أُلْقِيَ إِلَيَّ كِتَابٌ كَرِيمٌ إِنَّهُ مِنْ سُلَيْمَانَ وَإِنَّهُ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. For the first time, the full thing. And now this ayah that we teach our children when they are learning the Quran for the first time, now you know it's the first ayah that they, it's بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, because all the ulama have consensus in the Fatiha, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم is an ayah. So they receive it and they learn it. But it is something that we have to really live with. Everything we do is in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm here because I am here in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You eat your food. Your food becomes halal. You know the halal food that all of us are so anxious to receive. Alhamdulillah, I'm told that very soon there will be the authentic halal restaurant chains in Edmonton. Very soon, inshallah. You know, halal, how does it become halal? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the All-Merciful, the Compassionate. Now, I would like to not say end, but end the khutbah with a new beginning. End with a new beginning. And wallahi, Allah is my witness, I did not know anything about what I'm going to say now in 2 minutes and then finish. I did not know. Sheikh Sharif pulled me to his office and with other members of the community, and they said, you know, we are embarking on something called Light the Legacy. And we are going to do this and this and this and this and this and this. I said, subhanallah. For the first time, I'm hearing that the oldest masjid in Canada, again, is lighting the legacy for all Muslims in Canada and inshallah across the world. Inshallah. Because the project is not only to expand the masjid. The expansion of the masjid is just one thing. But there is education, there is a cemetery, there is old people's place. There is lots of things. Lots of things. white the legacy. And I said, Subhanallah, I'm going to talk about the legacy being the Quran. And here we are with the legacy from Al-Rashid Masjid. So I'm going to call you in the name of Allah, the All Merciful, the Compassionate. And Allah is my witness that I have delivered. Allahumma inni ballaght. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us if we had the ability and we refrained, that each one of us from $25 to $500 every month to make it sustainable, because the household you support is no more important to save you on the day of judgment than the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you will extend your support without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needing your support, He doesn't need us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us that privilege. Imagine, in addition to the household of yours that Allah assigned to you, you will say, I'm going to provide a support, and I will every month from $25 to $500 in order to see that the problems of the world, inshallah, will be taken care of and will be solved by a legacy that will be lit peacefully, so that they don't say that Muslims solve their problems by decapitating people, by slaughtering people. That's how they solve their problems. We solve our problems with more education, with more peaceful coexistence, with interfaith dialogue, with sharing our corn seeds with the people around us. Please do not hesitate. There are forms outside. I would love to see lineups to take the form and fill it and say, I've done my share. Ya Allah, I will continue to provide my expertise other than money. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وخطايانا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا، وذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وكن معنا ولا تكن علينا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم، ودعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.